Hello, good morning students, and welcome back once again to another video. But this is a little bit different because I have a question from one of the students. He asked me to explain the Fleming's right hand rule once again. But in order to understand the right hand rule, first you need to understand the electromagnetic induction. Okay, so what is magnetic induction? It was given by Michael Faraday. The previous thing that we studied was that when a magnetic field is moved around a conductor, then the energy is generated in it, electrical energy. So previously we studied that when electricity is passed to the conductor, it generates magnetic effect, and because of which the needle of the magnet showed deflection. Or if the magnetic field is strong, then the conductor experiences the force, and for that force, in which direction the conductor will move, we had the Fleming's left hand rule. Now it is the exact opposite. Now we are providing the motion, so we are applying the force. Understood? In previous case, electricity was provided and magnetic field was provided, so the force was generated. Now this is the opposite. We are providing the force, so the magnetic field is around a conductor and we are providing the force to the conductor. So if magnetic field is there and force is there, then the remaining thing is the electric current. So electric current will be generated in the conductor, which is the opposite of the first part, that is the force on the conductor. So if we are applying the force, then electricity will conduct, and if we are applying the electricity, then force will be generated. This is the same thing. So electromagnetic induction is that when a conductor is moved in a magnetic field, then electric current is generated in the conductor. I repeat once again, if a conductor is moved in a magnetic field, or if the magnetic field is moved around a conductor, then the current is generated in this conductor. Okay, so the question is, what is Fleming's left hand rule? So Fleming's left hand rule helps us in finding the direction of that current. So suppose if this is the conductor and we need to find the direction of the current, that is, either the current will move from this direction or it will move in the opposite direction. That is what you are supposed to find with the help of this Fleming's right hand rule. And this is the exact same thing as the Fleming's left hand rule. You have to take your thumb, your first finger and your second finger in 90 degree to each other. So like this, the thumb and the first finger is in 90 degree, and then you take your second finger and make it 90 degree to the thumb. And if you watch in this angle as well, then it is 90 degree to the first finger as well. And this is how you are supposed to find the direction of the current. Now, the thumb once again shows us the direction of the motion or in which you are moving. The first finger shows us the direction of magnetic field, that is magnetic field lines. So suppose over here there is north and over there there is south. So the magnetic field lines are moving from north to south. Magnetic field lines are moving from north to south in this way, and that is shown by the first finger towards the camera. Okay, and the thumb shows the direction of motion. That means if I am taking this conductor and moving it in upward direction, if I am taking the conductor and moving it in upward direction, okay, then by the second finger it will show me the direction of the current. That means as soon as I start moving this conductor, magnetic field is from north to south over here, so the magnetic force is going this way, okay, and I am forcing the conductor to move in this direction. So I am manually moving the conductor this way, so the current will be generated in this conductor, and the second finger shows the direction. That means the current will move from here to here. Similarly, if the conductor is moved downwards, then the magnetic field does not change, but only the direction of the conductor moving downwards is changing. So I replace my thumb from upward to downward direction. As you can see, my first finger is still pointing in the direction of the magnetic field, that is from here to the camera, and the conductor is moving now downwards. So as you can see, the second finger, my second finger of the right hand, is showing this direction. That means the current is now moving from here to here. I hope it is clear to you students. It is quite easy if you understand the concept of electromagnetic induction. Then the right hand rule only shows you the direction of the current flowing in the conductor, okay, either this way or that way, okay. It only shows the direction of the motion of the current, not the conductor itself, because this time you are providing the motion, okay. I hope that answers your question. Have a nice day. We'll talk more in the next video.